welcome. Today I'm going to be chatting about what is self-healing. So we have come to a time in all of our lives where it is time to start integrating the two sides of ourselves. So I feel like this is especially at coming into the full moon in Libra, because it's all about the scales and balancing the two parts of us. So the mask that we wear to the world that we show, and also to the part of us that we don't show to everyone, and maybe the ugly, iffy parts that we don't even want to look at ourselves. So I'm going to just be chatting about that shadow self a bit, because it is very important right now that we start to use the time to come into that shadow self and just bring it more and more up and to the surface. Because when we come out of this lockdown, or come out of this new phase that we've been using for transformation, nothing is going to be the same anymore. And if we don't learn how to just start healing from the inside out, we're not going to cope very well with what the changes are going to be when we come out of this. Because I do believe it's going to be a world that we haven't seen before, and we need to learn how to not be rocked by all the stuff that is happening around us, because we are so secure and safe within that whatever happens and whatever changes happen around us, we easily adapt and change with them and transform with them. So in saying that, I am pretty sure that we have all encountered some sort of knowledge or someone telling us now that now is the time to go inward, now is the time to obliterate the ego, now is the time to see every toxic relationship you've ever seen, you actually start seeing it for what it is, because you're so close with family members or partners or relationships that you may not be necessarily want to be in at the moment. So there's so much information going around us at this moment about that. Let's go inward, let's do this. But I do believe there's not enough information of how. How do we do this? Because we may have never had to delve into these deeper parts of ourselves that are emotional and ugly and just something that we don't want to look at. So we maybe have never had the opportunity, or also we just don't want to look at it because it's too painful and it's too rife and ugly. So I'm going to bring to you a technique that I use with a lot of my clients, and it's a self-healing journaling technique. So it's all about understanding what comes up, where it comes from, and how to not become that emotion. So if you see here, I've said emotion. So an emotion is energy in motion. It is a message that is being brought to us. So it is a gift. And the more and more we can start to see that, the more and more we can stop being afraid of them. And also, one of the important things to do with emotions is try not to sit and unpack inside the emotion and then become the emotion. And I do know, even in saying that, there's so much information about, oh, how not to become an emotion, but we don't know what to do when the emotion does arise. We're stuck with it, and we've never been taught what to actually do when that emotion is sitting with us right then and there. So I'm going to walk you through it. It's called the self-healing journaling technique. And one of the very first things we need to do is to witness. So I like to make it something tangible, see it in my hands, hold it like a ball, however you feel you would like to witness it. So you see yourself outside of this emotion, so that you know already that you are not that emotion. You are not one in the same. You are separate from this emotion. You're seeing it as almost like an email dropping into your inbox kind of thing. You have a look at it. You try and understand what it is. Is it anger, shame, guilt? Is it sadness? A lot of the time we may even struggle with this beginning step because we're so disassociated with our emotions that we don't actually even understand what an emotion feels like. So just keep on with this step. If you cannot move past the step right now, that is fine. Do what is right for you in the moment. So witness this emotion. Is it shame, anger, sadness? And see it as something outside of yourself. And then bring awareness to this emotion. So try your hardest not to disassociate your body from the emotion, or disassociate your mind and your feelings from this emotion. So we can sometimes easily repress that emotion, so we disassociated it from already, or it can come up and present itself in our body. So it could be back pain that is presenting, or neck pain, or a sore throat, or any of these things that may be coming up as the emotion. And we sometimes put this aside as being, oh, it's because I swept the floor yesterday, that's why my back is sore. So try your hardest to not disassociate and bring awareness to, where is that emotion? Is it in your back? Is it painful? Where is it? Feel it. Try and sit with that emotion. Ask yourself questions. Is it sitting in your stomach as IBS? Is it chest pain? Do you feel like you need to cry? Do you feel like you need to scream? Do you want to punch something? So that you are understanding more and more what this emotion is trying to, what this message is that is being brought forward for you. And then the third step would be the actual journaling itself, or asking questions. So you can do this on your phone. You can do it once you become more and more comfortable with it. It's something that can become a lot quicker and just happen in your mind. You witness it, you see it, oh, it's in my back. Okay, I see where that's coming from. There you go, I let it go, I understand it. But for now, the journal is really, really important to start becoming closer and closer to the message of what your emotions are saying. So what would you do? The first step would be to, what is the incident that triggered this emotion or this reaction? So say, for instance, you have a fight with your partner, or your partner does something that completely irritates you. You start to see the incident. Okay, my partner did this and it completely annoyed me, frustrated me, and I reacted by shouting at them, and I projected every bit of my trigger out of my mouth and onto them. So then you would ask yourself, what are the themes or the belief systems being presented here? Okay, so if your partner, say for instance, he called you out on something that maybe you were trying something new. Okay, so you were trying to wear a red dress instead of a blue dress, and he said to you, I don't think that looks very nice on you. So you projected everything that you've ever felt towards him in that moment. And the belief system might be for that, or the theme would be that you're struggling to accept and validate yourself because you've never been validated by males in your life. You've only had domineering males in your life, maybe. That could be one of the belief systems. So you seek validation outside of yourself. So now that he's telling you your dress doesn't look great, you believe him. You think that, okay, it's because I've been taught this my whole life that I need to seek validation outside of myself. It completely crumbles you, and that's why you react in such a way. If you struggle with understanding these themes in the beginning, you don't even have to know it at the time. Just write down the fact that there is a belief system here. You just may not be sure what it is right now. And you also can reach out and ask other people about that incident. What do you think that incident would be? What would those themes or belief systems be? Ask someone else as well. They may have a different perspective with that. And then also, what social construct or who taught you this conditioning or this belief system? So social construct would be, was it your mom? She constantly seeks validation from her partner by, oh, do I look good in this? She never trusted that gut. So when you grew up watching her do that, that was her who taught you that belief system, that conditioning, and just as her mother probably taught it to her. And the social construct would be that women must be submissive to males and ask them what they think before they do. So those would be just an example of that belief system and those And then also, I just ask you to bear in mind not to bring judgment onto the people that you that start to come up during this time for you. It normally would be your parents, your guardians, your teachers. They have just been taught conditioning just as you have. So when you feel ready, don't force it. Try to bring the compassion to them as well, that they just have wounds, and that is why they pass those wounds and that conditioning onto you. But you are taking responsibility now to overcome that. Ask yourself the question, is this belief system serving me anymore? If it isn't, then bring in the moment, what is the counteracting belief? What is the truth that you know right now to be? So this is where the rewiring of the brain actually happening. So this happens. This is when the reconditioning happens. This is when the reparenting happens. And it's the place where you take your power back and you take responsibility of all the things that have happened to you, and you actually become the victor and not the victim of those things that have happened. So you're taking ownership of this life that you want to live. So one of the counteracting belief systems that you would do then would say to yourself, I love this dress. I validate myself. I am worthy of knowing exactly what I want. I will wear this dress out no matter what people think of it. Okay, so that's counteracting and saying the truth to what you know it to be. And this is how we start to own our shadow self and start to witness the ego and how we can project this onto people all the time. And this is the way we move from being the victim to the victor of your life. So take that responsibility, take ownership through this, and I'll be snapping a picture of this and then post it as well so that you can see without all my rambling in between. Okay, thank you so much, everyone. I hope that helped. My cat always bombs my videos, but there you go.